Students, you are most welcome to the language class. Today we are starting chapter 3, that is singular and plural. In our previous classes we have already read that singular means it denotes one. When there will be one thing or one person, that will be denoted as singular. And plural means when there will be more than one. It may be 2, 3, 10, 20, any number, but more than one, that is considered as plural. So many things, they have the noun, those who have number, they have two forms. One is singular and another is plural. Now I am starting the chapter. In each sentence below, circle the singular nouns and underline the plural nouns. The wizards sat at the table. Wizards, plural. So we have to underline it. Sat at the table. Table, circle it because it is a singular noun. The spoons stood in a line. The spoons is a plural form. So underline it. In a line. Line is in singular form. So you circle it. Dishes appear from the wall. Do by yourself, the rest of the three will do by yourself. Now, we already know about the singular and plural nouns. We will learn something more about them here. Plural nouns state that there is more than one person, animal, place, thing or idea. Number two, most plural nouns are formed by adding s after the word. For example, trees, trees. Tree is the singular form and trees is the plural form. Next is cave, cave, singular form, caves. We are adding s to the word tree and cave and we are making it plural. Next, number three, if a noun ends with y, it takes ies. To become a plural. For example, factory, factory, we will, to make it plural, we have to change y in I and we have to add es. For example, factories, y, we have to take it out. We will not write y over there, we will write ies to make it plural. But in some cases, we will see that y after y, s is adding and it is making plural. For example, boy, b-o-y, we are adding b-o-y-s and making it plural because before y, there is a vowel. So when there will be a vowel before the y, we will not change it. We will keep it as it is and we will just add s over there. So remember this, two rules for y. When there will be consonant before y, we will add ies. When there will be vowel before y, we will just put s over there to make it plural. Number four, most singular nouns ending in f and fe changes to ves in the plural. For example, scarf, scarf, scarves, scarves. Next is knife, knife, knives, knives. Number 5. Singular nouns ending in s, double s, z, ch, sh, x and o become plurals by adding es after the noun. For example, bus, bus. We are making it bus, es, buses. Church, c-u-r-c-h, church. We are adding es to that. c-h-u-r-c-h-e-s, churches. Potato, potatoes, class, classes, bush, bushes. For some plurals, there is a change in the spelling in the singular noun. For example, man, men, woman, women, like this. Some nouns have the same form in the singular and the plural. Fruit will be fruit only in singular also and plural also. Fish. There are some rare plurals, children, oxen, okay, These are the rare plurals. These things you have to read. You have to learn from books. For example, number 9, some singular nouns are spelt like plurals, but they are actually singular in meaning. News, darts, trousers. I will wear my black trousers today. It is one trouser only, but it sounds like trousers, plural one. But no, actually it is a single thing, singular one. Next, choose the correct plural to fit into each of the following sentences. I will not discuss this one. You have to do by yourself. When you will get the answers, you will check there. But before doing, do by yourself. I am telling every time, do by yourself in your home. Don't sit for the answers. Next, number 2. Number 2, you have to, from the given yellow box, you have to sort out that the person, animal, place and thing and abstract noun, you have to segregate or separate. Then you have to make it plurals, okay? So do by yourself, you are in class 5. So these things all of you have done already. So do it and we will get the answers in your next class. So read the chapter, read this portion very, let's learn it properly, okay? So till the next class, goodbye, have a nice time.